Hello everybody and welcome to Silent Hunter 3, it's a Jack Wall Let's Play. I'm using the Grey Wolves expansion pack and I did actually have the resolution cranked up a little bit, but I'm not able to record with fraps if I have the resolution anything greater than the default in the game. So the resolution is back to the game default. You'll notice along the bottom that I am using the Silent Hunter 3 Commander, and we hopefully still have a decent Academy result. So we go straight into the game. Player we can delete, I don't know why that's there. Goodbye. Jack Wall, accept new career. First Flotilla was founded in 37 by Danitz, who went on to become the Commander-in-Chief. The base was out of Kiel until 41, and then in 44 it was disbanded, and it was with Type 2 boats initially and later switched to Type 7s. It's 1939, it's the 1st of August, it's a Tuesday. This is the boat. We'll not spend too much time on it here. It's all fairly default. I do want to have a look at the torpedoes. They're gas or steam driven, 44 knots with a range of 5 kilometers, 40 knots with a range of 7.5 kilometers, and 30 knots with a range of 12.5 kilometers. And they're straight run ones. We have 3 in the 4 tubes and 2 reserves. And that's it. We got 5 torpedoes. Wow. Well, that's the type 1s. Type 2s are 30-knot electrics with a range of 5 kilometers in straight run. Anyway. Okay, let's have a quick look at our personnel. We need to hire a petty officer and three sailors. This is what the boat looks like on the inside. It's pretty cramped, I'd say, in there. Let's just go for anybody who doesn't have qualification. Who's this guy? Paul Schultz doesn't, so goodbye, Paul. It was nice having you on board. And yeah, are you sure we are? So, Eberhard Eberbach, great name, is a watchman, a medic, and a repair. We have a watchman up here, and we have another repair guy, which is fairly okay. Good experience, so we'll stick with those. On the petty officer front, we just need one petty officer, and Robert Laudo comes recommended. On the sailor front, Freiherr Albrecht apparently comes recommended. And we have two more, so we're going to split it. Edgar Thompson, less experience, but hopefully he'll do the job. All these guys are pretty much the same as far as I can make out. And then we are going to go with Martin Rudolph or Brookhart. Brookhart, you're my man. You are the new guy. So that is the situation. We have a full capacity. And yeah, and we have no awards. Okay. Let's go and pick up a mission. GWX orders for August 39 are players starting in the 1st and 2nd flotillas are advised to run a 5-day shakedown patrol. We're on 87% realism. The event camera and the external view are still available to me for argument's sake. I don't intend to use them a lot. Let's start from there. Incidentally, players in the 7th are ordered to stay inside the bay and sink the target ships. Without incurring any damage. And then there's more orders that will arrive on the 4th of August, okay. We're in Kiel. So we shall do that as our game slowly builds its way up to getting ready. Hopefully without a problem, so I'll bring you back in once we are in the boat. Well, hello everybody and welcome back. Here we are in the cramped conditions that are our boat. Everything is pretty good. We've got our sonar guy up there. Apparently they've spotted a ship. Well, let's hop up to the bridge. Oh, hello. 163 is... Well, there we go. Well, alright gentlemen. We need to cast lines and prepare to take it out 4 knots.
Yes, sir. Current speed, 4 knots.
Current speed is 0 knots. I'm going to chart out a little bit of a course for us here. We're in Kiel. This is where we are. So I'm going to take us out basically out to here, out through the port, and we will adjust our way from there. That's 10 kilometers of a run. So, what the hell? We've got aircraft coming in. What aircraft are they? And should we be manning our flak guns? They're fairly friendly. We get an aircraft send-off. Okay, well that's good. Oh, that's nice. There's our compass. Do we have a compass here? No. We have a compass
ship
here.
Bearing 310. Long range. Yes, sir. New course. 8-8. Yes, sir. New course. 8-8.
Okay. Enough of that. Got these aircraft flying around. There's another one there. Air Force making loads of noise for what reason? Alright, so we are on our way out. Ain't that something? This is our boat and basically we're going to be using real navigation for most of the way. That's the plan, and we'll be making a turn here now anytime soon. Type 2 boat. Yes, fella. What do you think?
Ship spotted. Bearing
yes.
270. Medium range.
270. 270. Medium range. That'll be there. Yeah, I need to work out this bearing now. Bearing 270. North, south, east, and west. We're heading 90, which is east. 270 would be that way. And apparently there's a ship over there, and there is. And what is she? She's a great big warship. And she probably is a warship I should be able to recognize, but I don't. Alright. But you're kind of giving me a bit of a sly look, aren't you? You're just,
I'm not sure about you, Captain. I mean, you got those excellence, but I'm not sure about you.
That's okay. I understand. You're just dudes, man. It's like, what's with that? Anyway, we are, we're not doing too bad here now. We might be even changing course. What's our rudder doing? Nothing. Rudder's doing nothing. Yeah. We should be getting a bit of a turnaround going on here. We are too.
Ship spotted.
We're turning.
304 long range.
304 long range. It's kind of a tugboat that's bringing us out. Navigator, what's our depth?
Depth under keel is
1-2 meters. Huh. Okay, well, we are on our way out of keel. We're having a good look at the yards and the cranes and the warship, and are they still... They are, look, they're still waving over there. Oh no, they're just a group of guys that are working. Everybody else seems to have gone away. Yeah, they're just hanging around. Navigator, what's our depth under keel now?
Yes, sir. Depth under keel is 1-3.
So in reality, trying to play this game in real time would be brutal. Going to have to use a little bit of time compression. And if we use 4 as our time compression, then basically what blazes are we doing? We seem to have a little bit of a problem. That should correct that. Now, a little bit of time compression means that we can, if we use 4, then that's 15 seconds per minute, which means we can be getting around the place a little bit more. What's the word? A little bit more successfully. We got a ship coming in there that's neutral. Flying a Swedish flag, is it? Or is it a Greek flag? Cheekers, I'm gonna have to get my flags sorted out. Where's my flags? I need my flags. Is there flags down here? Navigation map, No, that's my details there, that's that. Flags, I need flags. Attack map. Flags. No information on flags. Reports, there's, got to reach grid AN21 and we've got to patrol for 24 hours, but sonar, what you got? You got any flags here? I got a watch that I don't like. I kind of have a feeling I'm going to be changing a few things here over the course of the next little while. That's a seawall there. And every time we go and look at something, she speeds up. Okay, well, let's hope that they're not going to crash into us. Ship spotted at 113 degrees, sir. We're a submarine. We can get out of our way. Everything is looking good in that regard. This is our fuel, and I believe that's our critical fuel red line there. Yeah. Where did that boat go? Where is AN-15 anyway? When we're going on about this. AN-21 is actually our... AN-21 is our job. We're coming out of keel here. AN-21 is up here. Bloody hell. Would it have been better to take the channel out of Kiel, get into the Dutch Bay here, and get up into AN-21 that way? Because what we're doing now is... Yeah. Change of plan here, folks. We're going to do a little bit of change of plan. We are going to maneuver ourselves through the channel. Hopefully without incident. This is possibly a little bit interesting. Trying to keep it in the middle and we should be all right, right? He says, like he actually knows what he's talking about. Up through the middle of there. And we'll crash into the land, and then we'll decide, actually not on this trip, we will crash, we'll just do a, what I call a crazy jack maneuver. We will suddenly and without any warning, we'll just make a sudden maneuver. Okay, we're 49 kilometers. Yikes, we got a lot. We're only halfway there. This could take a while. I mean, we're able to do on the surface a little bit more than that. We'll kind of push it up to a faster speed in a minute. Let's see how we're getting on here. We're into the ocean and we are turning. I don't know how good the map is. Actually, our map is not very good, but is there a bridge there? There isn't. Yes, there is. It says so as well. There's Levensoa, Hochbrücke, So we need to pass under that. I think that's
ship
something.
Spotted. Bearing 261. Medium range.
Well, I don't think we have to worry too much at the moment. But a bearing of 261. So navigator, what is our
ship spotted? Bearing 256. Short range.
Current position. Our navigator, how do I get him to give us our current position? Plot course?
Yes, sir. Plotting course.
He's plotting the course. Right, navigation officer is... Navigator is following the plotted course, which is good. Chief engineer is telling us that everything is fine. Weapons officer is telling us everything is fine. Radio operator is giving us a report. We have contact reports, sent patrol reports, radio messages, and the gramophone. And our deck officer has got plenty of going ons, including weapons management. But I really need to get our position here. Range to end is 48 kilometers.
Ship spotted. Bearing 241. Medium
range.
What
I really want to know is what is our switch to compass. So if we're heading 330, that
ship
is our heading.
Bearing 237. Medium range.
Bearing 237. So bearing 237 is over here, basically on our left side.
Ship
so if I go over here to 237,
short range.
That'll be that. No, it's a lighthouse, you dipshit. Although there's boats there, you see. What are they, French? That's German. Anyway, I shall bring you back in a little bit later. We are not going to be recording hours and hours and hours of play here. We do have to kind of find our sense of what's important and what's not. So there'll be a little bit of this intermixed here and there as I choose. But we are about to head down the bay, so... so that's what we're going to be doing. And we're going to head down the bay with a little bit of urgency. I wonder how deep it is here. Meters, so it's not very deep, but it's deep enough for us to submerge if we needed to. Which we don't need to. Okay, until later. Well, now we are making a little bit of progress here. But I thought it might be nice to actually have a look at our boat as we are traveling along here in the water. Pretty nicely. Cutting a nice little wave and heading our way out of Kiel, heading down into the canal. Everybody's cramped in that little conning tower. Overall, she's a small little boat, isn't she? But she's our little boat for now. Hopefully we'll have a little bit of success with her as we head on down into there. Need to be more gentle with the controls here. Under the water, there she's She's running nicely. Not very deep down there, is it?
Ship spotted. Bearing 240. Medium range.
What a bloody... I don't know if I would like to be in one in real life, or have been in one, to be honest with you. I ain't convinced. But anyway, thought I'd show you that for a moment, because everything is nice and quiet. Okay, I've been looking through some information here, and we're running at 11 knots at the moment, so we'll do about 20 kilometers per hour if we're able to keep this up. And at the moment that's an hour in real time, because we are running pretty much real time. What I'm thinking of doing here is extending our trip as much as we possibly can without having any crashes. So this could take a little while. We have some bridges here to pass under still. But essentially we would be trying to plot out some kind of a plan to estimate our length of time that we would need in order to patrol out to AN-21, which is kind of a little bit off. So we need to plot our way through this canal and we might have to do a bit of refining on this a little bit later, but essentially we are in a good position here now. We'll head up here. Now the other thing that I wanted to highlight here for a minute is I was looking here at the information that we have within the game, and it's telling us a little bit about what's going on in 1939 and what's going to happen in the future, which is fine because we know what to avoid. We're going to be coming out of Kiel, coming out of the canal here into Dutch Bay, or German Bay. And essentially, we're in 1939, so if we stay relatively close to the Norwegian coast, we're not going to be picked up too much by the Allied air cover, which can stretch out as far as this red circle here. And then we can carry on up towards our patrol grid of AN-21, which is kind of in that arena there. AN-21 is fairly well up into the Shetland Islands, it seems. So that is they are our orders, aren't they? AN-21. No doubting about it. So that's the plan here is to take ourselves, and I can do this now on the map in this view, is to take ourselves up along here, not keeping too far away from that, but not getting too close either, and then we would be into our patrol grid of AN-21 starting up here, and basically running our patrol like so. And then heading back. Well, if we go just as far as there, that's 2400 kilometers. And honestly, I'm not sure we can do 2,400 kilometers in this boat. We have a range at that speed of a little over 1,000 knots. So we're going to have to kind of slow down quite a bit here if we're going to be able to make that distance.
Yes, sir. Depth under keel is 2-0.
We'll slow it down to 7 knots. At 7 knots, we would do 8 hours would do 103 kilometers. 10 hours a little under 130. And the route we're taking is going to run us that far. We might need to start clearing this up a little bit. See if we can straight line a few things. Oopsie-daisy. Whoopsie! Now. That's a bit better. If we were to just go straight up to AN21 that way, it would be 1,476 kilometers. And that's actually quite a few kilometers less. We can still do our patrol pattern, and that's 2,000 kilometers. Which is quite a bit, actually, nevertheless. And I don't know if we have that range. I don't know anything about this. It's telling us that 1 kilometer per hour, 13 knots after, so 7 is 12 knots and 13 knots, so for 2 to 6 knots is considered slow, middle speed is 7 to 12 knots, and fast is more than 13 knots. Now we're doing 6 knots, so we're on the slow side, but we do have this is knots per minute. Now what we have up here, we had kilometers per that. Oh, this is a different thing. Okay. That's something else. What else do we have up there? Nothing else. Alrighty then, that one's underneath there. Okay. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with you because, to be honest with you, there's not a lot going on, and I'm not sure what the range of my boat is. I'm gonna have to go and do a little bit of looking up and orders and briefing, and do I have anything on the boat? What do I have in here? Shift F2, and that doesn't give me anything of any use that I can read. Engineer report. Fuel level is good. but maneuvers, emergency orders, propulsion. Navigator report. Time to last waypoint. Maximum range at current speed. That's yes, what sir. I want to know. The maximum range at the current speed is 13,637 kilometers.
Yes, sir. Current speed 10 knots. Current speed 11 knots.
Huh. So Schnell is 13 knots, middle speed is up to 12.
Yes, sir.
What are we doing now? 4,730 kilometers. That's a little different. That's a little different. We are about 2,064 kilometers. So that's enough for us to get back. And that's 90 hours, so yeah, we can run along here quite nicely. Based on, not that thing, but based on this thing here, and I can't zoom in on this, but it looks like AF is coming out to there. AN is in that, so huh. Looks like we're cutting past a little bit of that. That's AF. That's AN, and it just touches off the corner of that, so we're actually well inside that in 1939. So we might need to do a little bit of maneuvering here. That can go up to there. Oh, well, that kind of took care of that then. We are kind of staying tight up here. Then we can go over to our Shetland Island run. This is not going to add that much more on. It'll add a little bit more on. We have to patrol for 24 hours here. And yeah, I wonder how long it's going to be. $22.57. 45. That's okay, we can manage that. In the meantime, okay, well, that's it for now. I will bring you back in probably when we're out of the channel and heading up into the open country. I do notice a slight issue here, however, in that we have kind of created a problem for ourselves. That fixes that. Get us through that island and not, or get us between those islands and not through it. Good. So, until later. Hi everybody, I'm bringing you back in because as we're doing our shakedown, I've decided that we will make a few changes. We're still heading down the canal, as you can see here. Nothing too crazy going on. And I don't know why we did that, but we did. We've gone very quiet. Interesting. pop down here, we're still making noise. Huh. And now we're making back to normal noise. So what I wanted to do is show you that we've changed our interface. We've gone away from the old interface and we've got the One Life Crisis Gold Mark something mod, which we've downloaded. I have used this before and I preferred it, so I've decided to get back into it. And as usual, I've realized that I forget stuff, and so I need to familiarize myself with it, and I thought we would do that together. We do have some six dials here that are showing up on the side, which are basically the three dials that used to be down here in the right, with the buttons that switch them removed. So basically we do have the settings, if you like, for forward and reverse, as well as the speed dial. We do have a compass as well as a rudder gauge, and we do have two depth meters, one which is showing down to 25 meters in graduations, and then one which is down to 200 meters. Kind of a mini and a macro there. This little radio button here toggles that on and off. Down here we have the ability to increase our time compression. We're limited to 4 at the moment for some reason, possibly because of our depth under our keel. I have a thing in the way of the screen here, so it's not really easy to be able to see this. 12 meters is our depth under keel, so maybe we're limited because of that, although I doubt it somehow. But we're running along here at 12 meters. We have a 10 knot speed, and I guess that's... I don't know what that number is there. We are... Our rudder is amidships, and this is our course. We're kind of running on 262, 263. That's really useful, to be able to know our course immediately, because when I'm told that we have a bearing, a ship bearing 456 or something, 456 would be ridiculous, 246, then I will be able to understand, relative to the bearing of the submarine, where this ship is. So that's something that I need to still get used to. The time is in here. This is an overview of our resources. Basically, all three of them, or all four of them. And then over here on this side, if I radio click that, I've got my torpedo control unit, and then I have the six stations and the possible reports to pull up. And in the middle section here, I normally have just the reports, but if I touch off the bottom section here, then I can navigate around to the various different areas of the ship. One of them here being the torpedo control. Here is my tactical scope, periscope. Here's my observational periscope. We got some mouse problems here right now for some reason. Hello. Please tell me we haven't frozen. This here is the bridge, of course. This is our sonar room. This is our crew overview with our damage and various activities there. Here's our objectives. Excuse me, and our briefings. Here's our radio messages. This is the captain's kind of log, I guess, here. Then we have access to the flak gun, the artillery gun, and we do have the ability to open view still. I didn't mention these two at the front. This brings us back into the main compartment of the submarine, where most of the activity is constantly going on. And this is our map, which you will remember from earlier, which is still pretty good. However, in the map I do have this for my compass, I do have this as a ruler which goes around. This is kind of a reference set of gauges between knots and kilometers and minutes. So by running a line across where I need to, I can work out how many minutes to cover how many knots would give a kilometer speed. You know, you just basically, you can't really do it here, but if I was doing 8 minutes to do 8 knots, I'd be doing 2 kilometers an hour. I think that that's what that means. Anyway, that is that. Here we've got a little gauge which is just telling us the color of the water, and you can kind of run it over and see what it's like. So we are all in water that is less than 17 meters deep, and I've checked that a couple of times to find out. Here we have the two files that were individual pages previously, which are telling us our knots per kilometer and our knots per meter per minute, knots per kilometer per hour, which is our kind of ready reckoner. Up here we have some of the recognition charts for various ports of interest. And over here we have the chart which is giving us the overview of what's going on and what the water is like, basically. So that's that chart, and it's a pretty useful one, and the information is mostly the same. The tools are down here, and they're the same, and you have a couple of extra tools in here which makes for a big difference, because if we go down onto our submarine at the moment, which is way over here, and we set our compass rolls on our submarine, we are doing around about 270, and that's what's showing up down here. So this is a very easy chart to be able to find out what's going on, and the direction of your boat relative to north as a standard. So that's it. That's as complicated as it gets, but it is quite a nice interface, and it's one which I appreciate, because we've got this thing here. And this thing here is a very powerful tool for quickly calculating range, speed, and excuse me, that was a big yawn I couldn't control, and angle on bow, indeed. I'm not going to lie, I'm not entirely sure with confidence how to use it. I did learn before. I do know that this dial here is an important one. I also am looking for a scratch mark on here, which I don't see at the moment. There was one particular scratch that was important that used to be there. Well, maybe I'm mistaken. If we were to raise this up. And get ourselves onto that. We have to get ourselves stabilized. Which is, we don't have the stabilization turned on. There it is. There's the scratch. There's a scratch between the 60 and the 55. And I understand that scratch is important, but I can't remember why. There's another scratch there at the 15, by the way. So maybe I'm talking rubbish. But I need to go and look at One Life Crisis's tutorials to remind myself on the use of this tool, but that seems to be good. The observation scope is here, and is an entirely different type of scope. We can still lock onto our target in that position there. It does actually tell us what the flag situation is, for the various boats that we might pass, which is really, 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 really useful. And I say all of those reallys on purpose because, frankly, that's something that is critical. We had a couple of boats that were inside the Kiel Harbour earlier, which I was somewhat struggling to identify. I believe that they were German, but you never know until you kind of get used to them, and I had forgotten those maps, those flags as well. The recognition book is in here, which is pretty useful. It kind of goes through the various countries that are in here, and then you can go through the various boats. So looking at the flag first is going to be important to establishing what's going on there. In any case, you can bring up the targeting and the engine controls anytime you like, basically, and we'll bring down the scope here now. And we'll return back to the bridge and make sure everything is going according to plan. Let's get another depth under keel.
Depth under keel is 1, 3.
Okay, so that seems to be fairly standard now, and we seem to be okay. We are able to do a little bit more speed here. I assume that that's going to be based on the fact that we are in safe, straight territory, which is good. So anyway, that is the latest. I'm pleased with this interface that I found it. I have uploaded it using the JSME mod controller. It's the only mod that I'm running with the version 3 of GWX Gold. So all of the other mod options that were installed with GWX, I'm actually not using them at the moment. We may add in some other ones as we go along, but for the time being, these are the ones that we will be using. And I believe it's good. Maximum range at the current speed is 5,551 kilometers. And the time to the last waypoint is 118 hours. Now, if there's 24 hours in a day, 48 is 2, 72 is 3, 96 is 4, 120 is 5. So, basically, by the time we complete our sweep of grid Alpha November 21 or Anton Norbert 21, Einen Atlantik. I'm not sure what the code is in German, and I should know actually, because I should be in a way of finding out anyway. That's going to take up most of our 5 days, so we are not going to maybe be able to get back to dock as suggested. But we are geared up and we're good to go, and I don't know who the chef is yet, but we need to talk to them. Let's see what our food situation is down there. There is a mod that one can use to that's the radio in there. There is a mod that you can use which will put loads and loads of we've kind of changed the interior here a little bit, I think. Have we? Interior aft. You can't open that. There's bunks there. There's a mod, I don't ever finish my sentences, do I? There's a mod where we can have hanging food and crates of apples and oranges, I mean, and various things that would be available to be seen. That map is looking quite clean and tidy and useless. What's going on there? What is going on there? So we might find that mod and put it on just for some, you know, some atmosphere. There's an Enigma machine, and the guy's driving the radio like us. Interesting. Here's our sonar guy up here. He's keeping an eye on things, doing his job.
Impressive.
So that's it, basically. That is how cool it is down here. Until later, go handy.